1901, Gregorio Cortez becomes a folk hero along the Texas border after he kills a sheriff in self-defense. 1902, U.S. occupation forces leave Cuba. 1912, New Mexico and Arizona become states. New Mexico's constitution guarantees Mexican Americans the right to vote, run for office, serve on duties, and use Spanish in public documents. 1916, Ezequiel Cabeza de Vaca becomes the country's first elected Hispanic governor of New Mexico. 1917, Congress grants citizenship to all Puerto Ricans. 1926, Ignacio Lozano establishes La Opinión in Los Angeles. Ramón Navarro stars in the Hollywood film Ben-Hur. 1928, Octaviano Lazarolo, former governor of New Mexico, becomes the first Hispanic to serve in the U.S. Senate. 1929, the League of United Latin American Citizens, LULAC, is founded to defend the civil rights of Hispanics. 1931, Diego Rivera paints his first mural in the United States on a wall at the San Francisco Art Institute. 1932, Benjamin Nathan Cardozo is the first Hispanic named to the U.S. Supreme Court. 1935, Dennis Chavez becomes the first U.S.-born Hispanic elected to the U.S. Senate, representing New Mexico. 1942, an estimated 300,000 Mexican Americans serve in the armed forces during World War II. The Bracero program brings millions of temporary workers to the United States. 1943, thousands of sailors and soldiers attack Mexican Americans in the Los Angeles Zoot Suit Riots. 1946, the GI Forum is organized to assist Hispanic war veterans. 1947, Ricardo Montalban makes his Hollywood film debut in Fiesta. The Community Services Organization, CSO, is established in Los Angeles to encourage voter registration and provide grassroots political support. 1949, Eduard Roybal is the first Mexican-American since 1881 to win a seat on the Los Angeles City Council. 1950, José Ferrer wins an Oscar for his performance in Cyrano de Bergerac. 1952, Congress changes Puerto Rico's status from protectorate to commonwealth. The sitcom I Love Lucy features the first Hispanic TV star, Desi Arnaz. 1959, rock and roll stars Richie Valens and Buddy Holly die in a plane crash. Fidel Castro overthrows Cuban dictator Fulgencio Batista. Thousands of refugees flee to the United States. Severo Ochoa becomes the first U.S. Hispanic winner of the Nobel Prize, which he wins in medicine for his synthesis of RNA. 1961, about 1,500 Cuban exiles make an unsuccessful attempt to overthrow Fidel Castro with the Bay of Pigs invasion. René Anselmo and Emilio Azcárraga, CEO of Mexico's Televisa, start the first U.S. Spanish-language television network, Spanish International Network. Rita Moreno becomes the first Hispanic actress to win an Oscar for her role in West Side Story. 1962, Cesar Chavez organizes the National Farm Workers Association in Delano, California. Jose Feliciano wins Grammy Awards for Best New Artist and Best Male Vocalist. 1963, in Texas, Jose Angel Gutierrez organizes the Mexican American Youth Organization, a model for student civil rights groups around the country. 1964, Jerry Garcia forms the Grateful Dead in San Francisco. 1965, Congress passes the Voting Rights Act. 1966, Oscar de la Renta christens his namesake company and wins worldwide fame for his colorful fashions. 1967, protesters from the Land Grant movement in Tierra Amarilla, New Mexico, make a citizen's arrest of District Attorney Alfonso Sanchez. President Lyndon Johnson establishes the Interagency Committee on Mexican-American Affairs. Rodolfo Corky Gonzalez publishes the epic poem Yo Soy Joaquín, I Am Joaquín. 1968, the Ford Foundation funds the Mexican-American Legal Defense and Educational Fund, MALDEF, to inform Hispanics of their legal rights and prepare civil rights cases. After an unsuccessful campaign to incorporate East Los Angeles, activists form the East Los Angeles Community Union, TELACU, to pursue Hispanic economic development. Lee Trevino wins the United States Open Golf Championship. The National Council of La Raza is founded to improve opportunities for Hispanics. Manhattan Project veteran Luis Walter Alvarez becomes the first U.S.-born Hispanic to receive the Nobel Prize, earned in physics for the discovery of certain subatomic particles. 1970, Patrick Flores is consecrated bishop, becoming the first Mexican-American elevated to the hierarchy of the Catholic Church in the United States. Linda Cordova Carter wins the title of Miss World USA. From 1976 to 1979, she stars in the TV series Wonder Woman. Roberto Clemente becomes the first Hispanic to join the Baseball Hall of Fame. Herman Badillo becomes the first Puerto Rican elected to the U.S. House of Representatives, representing New York. 1971. At age 22, Henry Cisneros becomes the youngest White House fellow in history. He wins a seat on the San Antonio City Council in 1975. 1974. Roberto Sanchez of Santa Fe becomes the first Mexican-American archbishop in the United States. Congress passes the Equal Educational Opportunity Act, making bilingual education available to public school students. 1975, Gary Soto wins the Academy of American Poets Prize and the Discovery Nation Award. Raul Castro is elected governor of Arizona, the first Hispanic to hold the office. The National Association of Latino Elected and Appointed Officials, NALEO, is established in Washington, D.C. to promote Hispanic representation in all levels of government. 1976, the Hispanic Congressional Caucus forms in Washington, D.C. 1978, Tom Flores becomes the first Hispanic coach in the National Football League. He leads the Oakland Raiders to two Super Bowl victories. 1979, Hector Barreto forms the U.S. Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. Hispanic Business publishes its first issue. Eduard Hidalgo is named the first Hispanic Secretary of the Navy. 1980, Frank Lorenzo takes control of Continental Airlines. 1981, Roberto Goizueta becomes the chairman and CEO of Coca-Cola. Henry Cisneros wins the election in San Antonio to become the first Hispanic mayor of a major U.S. city. 1985, Edward James Olmos wins an Emmy for his role in Lieutenant Castillo on TV's Miami Vice. Javier Suarez becomes the first Cuban-American mayor of Miami. 1986, Franklin Chang Diaz becomes the first Hispanic in space, heralding the occasion by speaking Spanish to the audiences on Earth. 1987, Hallmark Cards buys Spanish International Network and renames it Univision. Telemundo Group begins broadcasting. La Bamba emerges as the summer's blockbuster film. 1988, President Ronald Reagan appoints Lauro Cavazos as Secretary of Education. 1989, Dr. Antonia Novello of Puerto Rico becomes the first woman and first Hispanic to serve as Surgeon General. Manuel Luján becomes the first Hispanic Secretary of the Interior. Oscar Hijuelos wins the first Pulitzer Prize in Literature for the Mambo King's play Songs of Love. Ileana Rose Letnin becomes the first Hispanic woman and first Cuban-American elected to Congress. 1990, Sosa and Associates is named Advertising Agency of the Year by Adweek. 1991, Gloria Molina wins election to the Los Angeles County Board of Supervisors, becoming the first Hispanic since 1875 to serve on the board. Approximately 25,000 Hispanics participate in the U.S. Armed Forces during the Gulf War. 1992, Gigi Fernandez of Puerto Rico wins the Olympic gold medal for doubles tennis in Barcelona. Revenues from Hispanic companies reached $78 billion, according to the Census of Hispanic-Owned Businesses, published in 1996. 1993, Henry Cisneros becomes Secretary of Housing and Urban Development. Federico Peña becomes the U.S. Secretary of Transportation. Congress ratifies the North American Free Trade Agreement. 1994, California voters pass Proposition 187, which denies state education, medical, and welfare services to undocumented immigrants. 1995, Tejano singer Selena dies in Corpus Christi, Texas. Her album Dreaming of You, released posthumously, becomes the first album by a Latin artist to reach number one on the Billboard Top 200 chart. Sol Trujillo becomes CEO of telecommunications conglomerate U.S. West. In Adirond Constructors v. Peña, the Supreme Court allows affirmative action programs only in cases of proven discrimination with a strict scrutiny standard. 1996, Census Bureau reports that Hispanics have become the largest group of minority children in the country. President Bill Clinton nominates Aida Alvarez to head the Small Business Administration. 1998, Smithsonian Institution creates the Center for Latino Initiatives so that American history and culture may be understood and displayed in all its diversity. 1999, Carlos Gutierrez assumes the post of CEO at Kellogg Company.